Hey everybody, welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Banjo. Wow, just Hey everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play The Hey guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. I'm Josh Jepson, but you knew that already. Before I go into anything, before I forget, I'm going to head back to Spyro Mountain because there's something here that I missed the first time. I actually said that I was going to get it, and for whatever reason, I didn't. Like, I don't know, it must have slipped my mind or something. But anyway, if you come back to Spyro Mountain after you've gotten the, drill, what's-its-face, whatever it's called, drill, something or other, you come back to this rock just outside Banjo's house here, and fried mole. Ah, that's so much better! I don't know why the fish sounds like that, but shouldn't you be in the water where it's safer? You're right! I probably will dry up here and die if I don't get back to the moat around Spiral Mountain. Soon. I suppose you'll be wanting a carry then? Well, I'd walk there myself, but we goldfish are a little disadvantaged in the leg department. And you just collect him. A lot of people, and myself included, thought that you had to have a move from World 5 in order to do this, because the move allows you to carry things, but you just have to collect it and then drop it, and jump into the water, and he jumps out automatically. Ah! Now, these are gonna be virtually useless, really, for the most part. There's probably a couple times we're gonna use them. Like, I mean, it's not too much of a big deal, but basically, I believe he doubles your bubbles. Doubles your bubbles. Oh, I can see the title of the video right there. Anyway, so that's all I wanted to, I just want to get that out of the way. Wait, how many Cheeto pages do I have? Objects and items. I currently have 6 of them. So let's go get a move, or not a move, but a cheat. There you go. I swear to God, if this is what I think it is, then I'm gonna... Oh, I already know what it is. I believe. If I remember correctly. I don't know, my commentary... I swear, whenever I'm in freaking, like, the overworld, my commentary is like, bleh! Because there's nothing to talk about, there really isn't. But, we're gonna go back to Jolly Roger's Lagoon here pretty quick and go underwater. Probably in this episode, because the last couple episodes of Banjo-Tooie have been not in the water thingy. Can I talk to you, maybe?
Great, you've... got enough pages for me to tell you a new secret cheat.
About time, spill the beans.
Hand over my precious pages first. Much obliged. My second cheat is eggs.
Got it? Yes, eggs. They saw that one coming. I'll probably actually go in and put that in right now. So I will meet you there. Okay, and I'm back. Although that was like half a second for you guys, so I don't know why I'm saying another introduction or something. Okay, now I need to put in the cheat first. Dummy.
Duh. Dummy. Oh my god. You're so dumb.
Okay, yeah, eggs. This is easy. E. Where's the G? Where's the G? Where's the G? Where's... No, seriously, where's the G? Oh, there it is. And S right there. Alright. The eggs cheat will double the maximum number of eggs that you can carry. Yeah, just like the first game, that's nothing new. Dude, how do I get it? Oh, okay. That's weird, because you go into it automatically, but then you have, instead of pushing B like in the first game when you were in first person mode, when you were, dude. Instead of pushing B, you have to push the up on the C-pad, as if you were coming out of first person mode anywhere. Which I guess makes sense, but it's just confusing. Alright, I will meet you at Jolly Roger's Lagoon. Okay, hey guys, back in Jolly Roger's Lagoon. Yeah, I just wanted to get that out of the way, because I know a couple people have been commenting about that, and I just wanted to get out of the way. That was kind of bugging me, too, because it seems like every time I go to sit down to record Banjo-Tooie, I always forget about going back to get the double bubbles. The double bubbles. I swear, that's gonna stick forever. Double bubbles. Alright, anyway, so, I believe it was last time on Banjo-Tooie, we came down here, well, we didn't come down here, but we, activated the oxygenated thingy from Mumbo. Now we can traverse the underwater world without fear of dying from lack of breathing. now you'll notice these big-ass squid freaks. I'm gonna shoot some. We're gonna finally use put our ice eggs to use. And this is actually a pretty cool thing. You can actually use or swim around as Banjo and Kazooie. Well, I mean, in first-person view, so you're not like completely stationary for like you are on land. You know, like same with the air, you can fly around and you're not completely stationary. Oh, well, there's no thing in there. Oh shit. Which I think is pretty awesome, for when you want to get these things and not, like, mess yourself up by switching camera angles a million times. That way you can just go and aim at the thing and get it before, like, and then go, instead of going like this and then trying to get it, and then fucking it up, and then doing it again, and it's just annoying. Now you're gonna notice here, there's this big-ass, like, round UFO thing, but it's got Kazooie's face on it. Why aliens seem to have Kazooie's face on their spaceship, I don't know. Maybe they worship Briegels in the outer space? Who knows? So we can't really do anything with that right now. But trust me, we will be able to soon enough. Oh, well, I wasn't really close to that. I'm surprised I got that first time. I'm gonna be honest with you, these stupid-ass octopus guys really messed me up the first time I played this game, and the second time I played this game. I didn't know you could freeze them until just recently, even. So that was a bit of a shocker to me, you can imagine. Now, before we go off and get any major jiggies, this has got to be the easiest, next to the one in Mayhem Temple, I guess, this is going to be the easiest one, the easiest treble clef to get in the entire game, because it's just right here. It's just like getting any other regular note. It's not hidden or anything. Okay. So, well, I guess I see some notes already, so I might as well go get them while I'm here. There's also a warp pad here. I might as well get that now in case I die or something and go back to the beginning of the level. And if I go back to the beginning of the level, there's a warp pad right there, so I can just warp down here. It's pretty easy. Pretty awesome. Pretty sexual, I don't know. I'm trying to think, because I'm going to want to move. Alright, so we'll do this first. You can see all these statues down here with, they're like holding a pod up or something. Like Link wants to come and smash them. If you notice over here, there's a closed door, and above it, there's a bunch of Greek symbols, of which I can't name, so I will just call them by what they look like. Wait, I didn't even read it, I just was like, oh, Greek symbols, I didn't even read it. Okay, horseshoe, pie, triangle, lightning bolt, horseshoe, pie. Close enough. Obviously, those are not their Greek, names, but yes, that's what I'm going to call them, because Well, and you'll notice that down here, on the front of these pots, there's the symbols, the little symbols. You have to find the right one. I believe it was horseshoe, pie. Oh, that one's right there. All right, there we go. That was weird. You don't actually have to hit them, like, right on inside the pot or anything, because you can't, like, fart eggs into them down here, so. Triangle. Lightning bolt, and then I believe it was pie. If I get this from just memory, nope, that didn't make a noise. Oh, do I have to start over? Okay, horseshoe, pie, triangle, lightning bolt, horseshoe, and then pie. There we go. Easy as pie. Easy as horseshoe. Okay, where's the door? So far, I've got, like, three quotes that I want to use for the title of this video. I'm gonna have a hard time deciding. Alright, so we're gonna go in this place and see what's up here. I'm hoping it's nothing that's gonna take me too long. Oh, okay, I know what this is. Yeah, this isn't gonna take me long at all. Just a minute or so, I don't know. I think it has a timer of some sort. But anyway, hello.
Hello there.
Oh, hi. I'm Chris. Chris? I'm very pig-like, if you ask me. Actually, it's Chris P. Bacon. Oh, I see. What are you doing, Mr. Bacon? I'm on vacation, trying to photograph those lovely paintings on the wall down there.
Sounds fascinating.
Oh, it is, but these awful fish keep attacking me. Why not get a spear gun? A spear gun? Only you would suggest that, Kazooie. It's too expensive. I had no doubloons left. Perhaps you could protect me while I'm down there instead. Yeah, sure, why the hell not? You look like a rich fellow with your Game Boy camera. I'm sure you'll have a jiggy on hand to give me as a prize. Oh, shoot, he's going down. I didn't realize I could control myself there. Now, the easiest way to do this is, believe it or not, just wait. Hope you're ready. Here they come. Stand right here, sort of right in the middle, and shoot these guys. Here, I'll use regular ones. Alright, okay. Now, this can get kind of tough if you, like, you fuck this up, but just... I just hope none of them appear where I can get them. I heard one appear. This is actually kind of nerve-wracking with that music. Oh, are you serious? Oh, now we have to go up and activate it again? Oh, no. That nipper bite really hurt. Please try harder next time. Do you want to try again? Yeah, why the fuck not? Alright then, if you could just follow me down to the bottom. I'm already down to the bottom, you asshole. There's actually a cheat that I can go and get, but I actually decided it was too cheap. Somebody mentions it. The people that play the game, I don't want to spoil it because it's kind of cool, the cheat that you get. And I'll definitely get it for later because I'm going to want it for... No! No, please don't! Thank you! Oh my god, that was so close. It was right there, right at his face. He was about to bite his nipples off. Oh my god. Alright. Yeah, no, there's a cheat that we can get, and people pointed out when I was screwing up on Mr. Patch that the cheat does actually help, and I didn't realize you could get it that time, but apparently you can. Yeah, but there's a cheat that I can get with some of the stop-swap stuff, and I don't want to spoil anything, but I'll pick that up later, because I'm going to want it later in the game. Not necessarily right now, because I find it kind of cheap. Like, that game right there would have been way too easy with the cheat that I'm thinking of. Anyway, so let's get our jig and get the hell out of here. This place freaks me out with all those piranha in here. Piranha 3D. Alright, I'm not sure how much we have time for, but I might as well go and grab a move while I'm here. Now, the question is, where the hell is the move? I'm not entirely sure which one of these buildings it is in. It is in, but, please tell me it's this one. I believe this is where it is. Ow, if you don't get shocked by this asshole. Okay, so up in here, up in the top of the eel's whatever, eel lair, whatever the hell it's called, there's move right up here, and this is like the only thing in this place, so... Use it wisely! I don't know. Talon Torpedo! What?! Zed launches a bird and watch her go through the air like through the air? Through the water like a torpedo she'll go. Something. Push A for... Jesus, man! In the air! You're not in the air, you're in the water! Dummy. Oh my god. Duh, dummy.